Now, with the Chinese being excluded and the Japanese presence being questioned, American entrepreneurs tried another route. The first group of Korean workers are going to come to Hawaii in January 1903 to fill in gaps created by problems with Chinese and Japanese workers. So these Korean emigres had been influenced by Protestantism ever since two American missionaries went north or went to Korea in 1884. And these Protestant pioneers are also going to establish the first American educational institutes in Korea. So these and similar schools established soon afterwards facilitated the rapid expansion of Catholicism and Christianity into the Korean common population. And in time, it enabled the Protestant faith to overtake Christian Catholicism as the leading Christian voice in Korea. And between 1904 and 1907, about 1,000 Koreans are going to enter the mainland from Hawaii through San Francisco. Many Koreans dispersed along the Pacific coast, and they would work as farm workers and as wage laborers in mining companies and as section hands on railroads. But like the Chinese, Japanese, and Filipinos before them, the Koreans faced the same quote-unquote yellow peril hysteria. Again, when looking at immigration in the U.S. from Asia, how competent are Americans in their ability to distinguish people from their diverse nationalities and ethnicities? Chinese, Filipino, Japanese, Korean, you know, Americans can't tell the difference amongst these beautifully diverse people. All Americans do is notice their eyes and their skeptical faces. So how much do prejudices interfere in the American appreciation of any people, of their culture and of their traditions? See, racial prejudices make it easy to stay ignorant. Now, the Korean Presbyterian Church here in Los Angeles established itself in 1906. It began as a mission and a financial support center. So, as Koreans, Chinese, Japanese, and Filipinos became specific targets of hateful propaganda, shocking tales of how Japanese wanted to invade California, shocking tale of how the Chinese are going to take over this white man's nation, shocking tales of how Asians came to steal anything of wealth, all of this became widespread. And the Asian Exclusion League even tried to pressure the San Francisco School Board of Education to segregate all Asians, keep them away from white students, because they'll contaminate them. But all of this failed. But of course, for white males, it was important that they prevent Asians from interacting with innocent white virgin women. And the idea was to protect innocent white virgin women from the mongrel horde. Asian men were forbidden from intermingling with white women. Hence, we get the term picture brides and Chinese paper wives. Now let's take a look at picture brides. Asian men are going to be forbidden from intermingling with white women. And to replace the threat, immigration officials will allow for the importation of women. Picture brides became a common practice for marriage to Japanese, Korean, and Chinese men. Now, the term picture brides refers to the practice in the early 20th century of immigrant workers, and this was chiefly Japanese and Korean, in Hawaii and the west coast of the United States to select brides from their native countries via a matchmaker who paired bride and groom using only photographs and family recommendations of possible candidates. Immigrant workers sent their photographs to a matchmaker either in Japan or in Korea, who then matched his photo with the photo of a young woman. And the woman's family and matchmaker would work together to select a suitable mate. And the bride-to-be would be sent to Hawaii or the West Coast, with a legally binding contract for her, or to her, and this contract she was bound to the new husband once she landed on either Hawaiian or U.S. soil. So because many of the immigrant workers hadn't had photos taken of themselves since their immigration to either Hawaii or the West Coast, and since photographs were quite expensive, many immigrant men sent their matchmakers false or out-of-date photos, thus making the grooms appear to be much younger than they actually were. So the picture brides, because they're bound by contract to the man, upon arriving, they're going to discover this deceit, and the picture brides had no way of backing out of their contracts.